Hey, Teddy Bear. Have you ever wondered how players interact with each other in a Squid Game?
Hello, Zippy. Great question.
In the Tug of War game, players get to choose their teammates. And this choice is probably based on how good or bad the relationship is between players. Yeah, no one picked the old man. But player 456 felt sorry for him and chose him as a teammate. The girls are not popular either. Maybe others think that winning the game takes strength. So, it's better to choose a guy. Can we use data science to explore how players communicate with each other?
Totally!
That's a fantastic idea. We can use the social network analysis technique to identify patterns of social interactions. We can use graph theory to understand social structures. To build network graphs, we need two components: players and relationships. That's right, Zippy. A social network graph contains dots and lines, whereby the lines connect the dots. So the dots represent the players and the lines represent the relationships.
For this game, you will play in teams. Please divide yourself into teams of 10 people.
Let's use social network analysis to find out how players pick their teams. To start, why don't you install RStudio, Zippy?
Copy that.
Installing. Installing. Done. Now, let's install a package called iGraph.
Okay.
Let me Google. Loading. 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 And done. Now, you can bring in your dataset, Zippy.
Got it.
We have two datasets, one for the edges and another for the nodes. What are edges and nodes, Zippy?
Well, each node is a player, and the edge represents whether players appear together in a scene.
Ah, so players that appear together more frequently have more chances of communicating and therefore are more likely to choose each other as teammates of the tug of war game.
That's right, Teddy Bear. In this example, we can see that Ali and the old man appeared in 5 scenes together.
Now let's create the iGraph object. We can use the graph from data frame function, which takes the edges and nodes.
Got it!
We can visualize the network using the plot function, and we can create a new color variable to show nodes in 3 colors.
That's a great idea, Zippy.
Let's use red for players in the gangster group, gold for player 456 and his friends, and green for the other players.
Okay.
Plotting. Plotting. And done. That looks great, Zippy. Look, the social network analysis shows that the head gangster, loud woman, and doctor interacted more with each other in red.
Yeah,
and in gold, player 456, player 1, Ali, the girl, and the scholar had a lot of interactions with each other. Which is why these players were all on the same team for the tug of war game.
That's right, Teddy. But the gangster group didn't pick the loud woman, as they wanted only men.
Yeah, Zippy. Network analysis couldn't pick up on other nuances of the relationships.
Let's watch the tug of war game, Teddy. Let's see who wins.
Today's game is tug of war. To win, you must pull the rope and drop your opponents. Now, I will draw numbers to decide which teams will compete. The team that will play on the left tower, team 4, please stand up. The team that will play on the right tower, team 5, please stand up.
Come on, don't lose hope. All you need is a good strategy and teamwork. When I was young, I would always win this game. First, having a good leader is important. Second, you need an anchor, someone strong at the end of the rope. Third, alternate people on the left and right side of the row. Finally, once the game begins, lean back, practically lie down until you can almost see the person behind you.
Now is our chance.
Pull, pull, pull. Go, 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 go.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Teddy? Is that you? Teddy? Teddy?